I see more and more people coming into my clinic wanting contouring. Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. I'm talking facial contouring today. And we're gonna talk about particularly the lower face. This is tough because this is where the fat comes down. And as we age, volume goes there. We never really wanna add to that area, but people want jawlines. They want masseter reduction, but really they're trying to get rid of the fat in the lower face by the edge of the mouth. So what do we do? How do we do it? I'm gonna talk to you about 8 ways. Some of them are things that you can do at home. And I'm also gonna talk about what absolutely doesn't work, in my opinion, for facial contouring. First of all, let's go through 2 things that I've never seen work. Number 1 is topicals. There's nothing that can go in and dissolve fat topically or create enough lift to get rid of anything there. So we'll throw that in the garbage can. Number 2, I see all the time, and my patients ask me too, facial exercises. Nothing like that works. I've never seen it work. There's multiple videos on YouTube about it. If you've seen it work for you, let us know below in the comments. But it's something that doesn't work and it can create other problems as well. Let's go to what you can do at home. Number 1, losing weight. Okay, this does work, and people who carry a bit of weight or have gained a little weight, they'll see they've lost contour. Losing weight works mainly in the youth. People that are a little bit older, when they lose, they'll say, hey, I might come in later after I've lost some weight to do some contouring or lifting. But really what happens is there's enough loss of collagen that little bit of fat, it still sits where they don't want to. So losing weight does help, but it's likely not the complete answer if you're over the age of 35, 40. The next one is exercise. Exercise really does work, and I see it. People, of course, might lose a little bit of weight, but when you exercise, there's other factors that go into it. And how you know, people will look at someone who's a little leaner through exercise and say, hey, you've lost weight. And they're looking a little at the body, but really they're judging the weight of the person by the face and really by the shape and the contour. So I really think exercise is one of those things, with or without weight loss, but typically weight loss goes with it, that really does help shape the face and reduce some fat in the lower facial region. So that's something you can do. Number 3, one thing that I love is radiofrequency facial contouring. And we do this with a device that we can hit various depths, but when we get to the right temperature at the right depth, I don't think we're killing the fat cells as much as we're shrinking them down. And I've done this for many years. It's been done since 2003 in this country. There were radio frequency devices, and you'll hear some people get high frequency ultrasound. They say, I think it took fat out of my face, sometimes in areas they don't want it gone. But when we contour, it does shrink the fat, and it contours very nicely, works with fillers and the rest of the procedures we're gonna talk about. Number 4 is illusions, and this is probably the most frequently done. What are we doing? We're putting fillers, collagen stimulators in along the cheek, in the preauricular, in the jawline sometimes, creating illusions of contour and height. And I love this. This works very well as long as there's gain in those areas. We don't want to overfill to create it, but it does work. Number 5, everyone asks about the quick fix, is Botox or Botox-like treatments. Remember, we can reduce the masseter's works very well. If people are a little bit older, when we reduce the masseter, of course, what happens? We need to fill that area now. If you're losing teeth, grinding, it makes a lot of sense. And if people are younger, they have tighter skin, you can reduce it without getting the downturn. So it can work, but it can also be a problem, especially over the age of 35, 40, where you can get some downturn of the mouth from it. But it is an option. Number 6 is fat dissolving injections. Belcura in Canada, Kybella in the United States, around the world, phosphatidylcholine, deoxycholate. That works very well. If people have too much fat, you're better off getting surgery. And we're gonna talk about that and show you a video on that as well. But that procedure, if people have a bit of patience, you can get a little bit of swelling, and they don't have a lot of fat to reduce, and we've contoured with fillers and things like PlasmaSculpt can work very, very well. The next one is PDO threads, and this works very well, barb threads lifting, as long as we've contoured first with fillers, or we plan on doing that if necessary. If there isn't an area we can fill, the threads alone then do work very well. The last one I want to talk to you about is surgery. And for people with a lot of fat or they just want to have it done in less than an hour, there's not much recovery. You can go through the mouth, make an incision, remove the buccal fat, sew that up, that heals, and you can still do the other treatments after, the minimally invasive ones, but for many people, surgery represents a good option, especially if they don't need a facelift at the same time or other procedures. So there you have several ways to contour, some things you can do at home, some minimally invasive, some injections, and then a surgical route. One thing's for sure, everyone wants contouring, reduction of fat, lifting, cheeks, lip, chin, and jawline, projection, and contouring. Thanks for joining me in this YouTube channel. Stay tuned here and on Instagram. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.